winter in December. It was a freezing cold day, and I saw this man playing in Tompkins Square Park, and he was all alone. He was playing to an empty park, and I had to film it. If you haven't seen it, I'll give you the link. It's extremely moving. And I wrote it, and he's homeless. He wants to continue to compose music and play music, and he's really old. I mean, we're talking a serious senior citizen, and he's homeless, so he's poor, but he's got this saxophone, and he plays Begin the Beguine. I might pronounce that wrong, but anyway, it was deeply moving. And the next thing I know, I'm getting emails. The first was from Tim Madison. It was so moving, and we talked. I don't normally give out my phone number, but I took a leap, and he told me the historic significance, because basically Giuseppe was becoming famous in the 1960s, and he'd cut two records. To this day, I get emails from people all over the world. They have the records, they love the records, they remember him. Some of them have met him in New York City. So I rocked the jazz world. People thought that he was dead. When they saw my YouTube, they found out not only is he alive, but he's still playing music, and he wants to write music. And by the way, he's just cut a very small, I'd say like a homemade somebody from the neighborhood, who I think their label's called Tompkins Square, made a new CD. And I think his original record label re-released. Now, the New York Times hasn't covered that. It's interesting. The New York Times published 9 of my letters, and the New York Times hasn't covered this. And there was a movie with Robert Downey Jr. I can't think of it. I read the book. The book was good. I'm not going to see the movie. But, you know, that's L.A., and we're in New York. It's a similar story, in a sense. Very haunting. I'm not going to tell you where Giuseppe was and why people thought he was dead. I'm not going to tell you that this morning. But this email that I got is so beautiful. I just want to read you a little bit of it. Hope you're well. You are a godsend. Mr. Logan's son, Jay, is a longtime friend of mine. We were teens. He used to tell me about his dad, was a well-respected musician, of which now has been confirmed when he sent me to YouTube to see the clip 1966. You see, Pete Gershon from Signal to Noise, he's a publisher of this magazine, Signal to Noise, wrote an article about my YouTube, and this one from 1966. It was a British filmmaker, and we both filmed Giuseppe. It's almost 50 years apart in Tompkins Square Park, and it's deeply moving because the clip from 1966, which I'll also include in the text portion, there is Giuseppe with his little son, and he's playing in Tompkins Square Park. He's in this children's park that's still there today, and these little girls are playing with him. They just love him, you could tell, and that must be Jay. And he says that he's been following the progression of my YouTubes to see the progression of his dad is making with the help of beautiful spirits like yourself and the musicians. That's Matt LaBelle is really key, but there's a group of musicians. It's beautiful. And Jay was unaware of the developments in his dad's life since he directed me to the clips. I described to him as best I could all that I could remember. He was genuinely touched. There's more to the story, but basically he asked me to relay a message. As soon as feasible, he wants to have a reunion in New York and also hopefully record with him. It's deeply moving. I just, I'm overwhelmed. I don't know, you know, I'm just telling you what I get from this email, but I'm deeply moved and I had to share it with you. I tried to call Giuseppe, but of course his phone is not working. He has to put money on that phone. And you remember I gave him money. I don't think it ever got to that phone for minutes. But anyway, I had to tell you the great news.